Okay, I want you guys to envision a small child having an asthma attack. Some of us have kids, grandkids, and we can relate. Now, it's a really scary moment for both the family and for that poor child. They're in that crisis. After that kid is stabilized, I come in with the fancy discharge paperwork. And that's how to make sure that they don't come back, because I don't want them dying. I don't want them not knowing what to do. So now I give them this discharge paperwork. After that, I started thinking, what if we did discharge summaries different? What if we just gave them a coloring book and we colored with them? Sounds futuristic, right? I actually did that last week in the office. What I did is took all the discharge instructions and I boiled it down to just basic units. So if I want to make sure that they don't come back, well, that means their asthma is going to flare up. So I need to teach them how their asthma is going to flare up, how it's going to come back. So now I literally go through and I color every little thing. They may be allergic to dander, they may be allergic to animals, and I sit there with the kid and we're coloring together, going one by one. And then the medication, I do the same thing with the inhaler. And I thought, man, this is the best way to deliver healthcare. And then I thought, man, what about the countless others that don't have this access to this personalized care? The truth of the matter is, healthcare is under crisis. We're facing a global shortage of 10 million healthcare workers around the world. What that means is that millions of people will not have access to basic healthcare. It honestly breaks my heart. We need to do something, and to me, that something is AI. I truly believe that AI has the potential to help us during this crisis, help us navigate these waters. Now, I want to introduce to you this lovely lady, Courtney, and her dear son, Alex. You see, Alex was just 4 years old, and when this happened, his health began to decline. And when his health began to decline, like any other mother or parent, what do? You seek medical help. Well, this poor lady, she went to 17 doctors over 3 long years. 17 doctors. She talked to them, she reviewed, they did everything a doctor would do, medical tests, MRIs, CAT scans, blood work. The doctors consulted with each other. This poor lady, seeing her son suffer, think of a five-year-old running around and all of a sudden now he can't walk. And nobody knows why. And it's been 3 years. Well, fast forward, she did what everybody would do. She did everything she could, but she's like, you know what? Let me enter this thing into AI. So she took all the stuff that the humans did, all the medical records, all the tests, all of that stuff, put it together. She put it into AI, and within seconds, it gave her the diagnosis. It did what 17 doctors couldn't. Granted, they took that information to put it together, so technically it's humans and AI. But my point here is, what a way to deliver healthcare. What a way to address this crisis. Now, I just mentioned the coloring book. This was really fun. My kids love it. But I have older kids, right? So now I thought, well, let me use AI to make comic strips. Because how many times have you gone to a doctor and you get these papers, you're like, oh my gosh, I'm not going to read all this stuff. But if I make it fun, if I'm understanding, I'm speaking their language, now they get it. Now they actually want to read this thing and we can have fun. I've been traveling around the world, having a lot of fun, and I have something called accent envy. I don't like my voice. I really don't. And so now I can use AI to create 54 different languages, which is kind of crazy. So I got to show you a quick demo.
Don't worry. I'm here with you. Together, we'll manage this, and you'll be feeling better soon.
Now, I know some of you guys are like, that's creepy, but I think it's cool. Now, the other thing is I have a Hispanic population, and I gotta practice my español, so.
No te preocupes, estoy aquí contigo. Juntos lograremos esto, y pronto te sentirás mejor.
And now for my Japanese patients, I was like, I got you covered.
心配 しないで, 僕が一緒にいるよ. 二人で頑張れば, すぐに良くなるよ.
And now, the other thing is I have patients that are harder hearing, and I wanna reach out to them, I wanna speak their language, I wanna connect with them. So now I could take their discharge instructions, put it into AI, man, and now I can do sign language, which I still can't learn. But there it is. It's such a way to deliver healthcare. Now, I'm really passionate about this. I want to share why I'm so passionate about this. You see, when I was just 12 years old, I cut my hand on a jagged signpost. It was rusty. My poor mom, she's here in the crowd, she took me to the emergency room. We waited for 8 agonizing hours. It was horrible. In fact, that experience turned me away from healthcare, ironically. And as a result, I'm bleeding here, holding my hand with blood. Finally, the doctor comes in and he's like, let me stitch you up. And when he stitches me up, long story short, he uses no pain medication. That pain was horrible. But what lingered even more was this feeling that I was just a number. I was just another person in this broken system. It really broke my heart. And so when I look at this scar, I thought, you know what? It's making sure that we don't do this to other people, that no one else feels invisible like I did, like my mother did. Now, I want to make sure that I went into medicine, I became an ER doctor, so that no one feels like that. And so this is why this is so personal to me. So I feel like we need to heal healthcare by humanizing it, putting the human touch back in healthcare, feeling that love from your physician. You don't feel that often because it's just hard. They have to put that wall. We need to empower our doctors and our patients by creating tools to make you have better informed decisions. AI enabled, I truly see a future where we can use these tools to create those better diagnoses, like I just told you, to create better patient education, like I just showed you, and then to leverage these tools for the underserved areas around the world that need help. I really think AI will be this great equalizer in healthcare. We'll be able to do, believe it or not, we'll be able to serve about 1 billion people around the world using remote access, like you've heard of telemedicine and all these things. This is reaching out to people that wouldn't have access to this type of healthcare. I really, really believe it will be our great equalizer in healthcare. Now, medical knowledge, this is crazy. Medical knowledge is staggering. It's growing every 72 days, it doubles. Think about that. Doubles. To put it in perspective, if I was a doctor in the 1950s, medical data would double every 50 years. That's unreal. What that means today is I could take a sabbatical, take off 3 months, come back, I'm an outdated doctor. 3 months. Unreal. So how do I keep up with that? I truly believe we use AI to help me navigate through these waters, give me all these medical journals, all this information, and feed it to me in a way that I can understand and keep up and give the best care to you. Now, this human and AI collaboration, I'm happy to say, AI is not here to take jobs away or replace your doctor. Thank God. I see AI as a vigilant teammate, a teammate that's going to be there to help me make sure that nothing falls through those cracks. I'm an ER doctor at 3 in the morning. I'm human. I get tired. I truly just feel like I have nothing left, and I cannot make any mistakes. The stakes are too high. But if I have AI, making sure that nothing falls through those cracks, I'm giving the best care. Now, this is really personal again for me. Many of you guys, unfortunately, have had life-changing news where we were told X or Y, something happened. Imagine being told you have cancer. In that moment, everything becomes a blur. Everything the patient says, or from the doctor says to you, you just can't understand. Your heart, your emotions, all you could hear is cancer. This came really, really personal to me when my mom, that's right there, was diagnosed with cancer. She said, "Mijo, they said I have cancer," and in that moment, time had just stopped. It was as if everything was noise. I'm happy to say she's alive and well, cancer-free, and she's here with me today. But my point is, having AI to make that transcription when you are ready for that news, when you're telling a loved one, when I say, "Mom, what did the doctor say?" We have AI transcribing everything. So when you're emotionally ready, when it's 2 in the morning and like, "What did the doctor say? I'm trying to get a hold of him, but he's not answering," you have a transcript to understand. Now, I truly think we need to embrace AI. AI is not here to replace the human touch. If anything, it's going to free me up to give more of it. Think of it this way. While AI is doing all the repetitive paperwork, the discharge summary, the EMR, electronic medical records, all that paperwork is repetitive work. Give it to AI. Let it do that. Let it give me time where it matters. so I can have time to understand what you're saying, listening to you, truly doing what matters the most, which is time. And so I really see that AI can also help us increase our empathy. Use AI to teach doctors how to speak, how to communicate, have the AI analyze. That way, we're helping our patients. Because we're really good at learning medical stuff, but are we ever taught a class on how to speak? We're not. So we need that in healthcare. And as we move forward, I look at this car as a symbol of, I don't want anyone feeling invisible like I did, powerless like my mom and I did. I want us to do something different. So I'm asking my doctors, join me. Use AI tools to better create your clinical diagnosis plus AI together to create the best possible care for patients. And then I tell patients, use AI to better navigate your healthcare system, better understand what's going on. Use AI to help you create the best questions, because you only get 13 minutes with the doctors. Help it, use it together so that when you spend time with your doctor, you're really focusing for the best possible care for you guys. And then I talk to programmers. I say, programmers, use AI with your software capabilities together to create tools that are compassionate, that are going to create the best patient outcomes together. And so I'm really big on this following things. We need to use AI and humans together to create a better tomorrow. And I want to leave you with these last quick words. The one thing I want you to take away is the following. It's human plus AI will beat the best human or the best AI. Together, we're an unstoppable force, guys. Thank you.